we'll be out here for good. And we're here to change that. We want to displace, we want a down payment on displacement.
Yeah.
We are tired of the mayor and his pay-to-play politics. He won't even let us know who we're supposed to pay. So we're here to let him know that if he wants to have peace at his home, then we need to have some peace at our home. If he's going to upset our community, we're going to upset his community.
That's right.
Is anybody out here with me? Is anybody here?
Yeah.
Anybody here?
Yeah.
Because I ain't going up there by myself. The problem is it's in my yard today. But it's coming to a yard near you. Understand that.
That's right.
And so if we don't fight now, all of us are going to be wiped out. All of us have an expiration date in San Francisco. If you're not of the Twitter and the high-tech field, you have an expiration date in San Francisco. So I want you all, when we go, we want to make it known that we're there. And if the mayor don't know it, all his neighbors going to know it. I said all his neighbors are going to know it. We're here. It's no more business as usual. We're going to disrupt it.
Bust it up. Bust it up.
So I got two groups that are here today. And one, I don't know why we got to say this, but we have to say it. Black lives matter. For anybody who votes, black lives matter. I know the mayor don't believe it, but black lives matter.
That's right.
We're going to have her say a couple of words.
Come on, daughter. Talk to
me. Hello, everyone. I represent the last 3% of Black San Francisco. I'm a fourth generation Baby Hunters Point native. My family moved here, and during the Great Migration period, where many Black families moved here to work in the Navy shipyard. And so what we're fighting for today when we talk about displacement and eviction, we're fighting for the ancestors, the people who built this city, the people who made the city the metropolitan metropolis that people are so attracted to, what made the city what it is. And when we have mayors like Ed Lee who don't think about what built this city, the foundation of the city, it's easy for them to just kick us out and hand us an eviction notice. And also, it makes us lose our own stake in our land. So when we don't have financial literacy, we don't know how to hold on to our property, when we don't know how to pass down intergenerational wealth, then it's a form of genocide. All of these things are deliberately trying to oppress Black and brown people of the city. So displacement is not just about capitalism, but it's a very, very deliberate tool of white supremacy. And it's not by accident. 59% of Black wealth is tied up in housing. And when you think about that 59% of Black wealth being tied up in housing and the fact that people don't have a place to even rent today, it's criminal. And what that means is that if we don't have access to wealth, then we don't have access to the future. And if people don't have a place to live, then this whole Black liberation movement is for nothing. You know, if we don't have a place to even go to sleep at night, then this whole movement is for nothing. And so it's important that we fight to stay here, that we fight to raise our children here, and that we don't just go across the bay, we don't just go to Antioch, but we start evicting people because this is our city. You know, we deserve the right to be here. We can't accept this eviction. We have to stay here and fight to stay here. And if anybody should be evicted, it should be Twitter, it should be Uber, it should be Facebook. And we need to really talk about divesting from these entities and divesting from these people who don't have the interests of city residents, city native residents at heart, the working class people, the minority people, the immigrants who help run this city, who do all kinds of jobs and service for these techies who live here. So I just wanted to thank everyone for being out here and just bring awareness to the fact that displacement is not just a capitalist issue. It's a deliberate attack on black lives. So, power to the people.
Power to the people.
And we have another fight that's going on. It's called Midtown.
Midtown.
Jay, where are you?
Right here.
Come tell us what's going on.
Denver, Pascal, how you doing?
Yeah.
Our city.
Our city.
Our city.
Our city.
All right, that's a little bit better. I know that we're cold, but that's just the way the things are. This is how we have to deal, you see?
Yeah.
A week before Christmas, the powers that be forced us to come out here with the elderly folk, black community, and the youngsters out here.
Yeah.
Now, I come from the Fillmore Western Edition, but that does not mean that we do not feel the housing pinch like you folks do out here in Bellevue, Hunters Point.
Yeah.
All right?
Yes.
Now what we have is a very systemic effort to displace and banish working class and middle class citizens of color and otherwise from the city that we helped build. We're talking about Black Lives Matter, but we can't talk about Black Lives Matter without saying that Black Homes Matter.
Yeah.
We need to expand, preserve, the remaining 3% of the African-American population in San Francisco.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. At Midtown, we're facing what will be the largest displacement of the Western Addition residents since the times of redevelopment, when the bulldozers rolled through our neighborhoods, tore them down. My friends, my neighbors, lost their million-dollar homes to be left with nothing. Wow. And now they're being displaced as well. We will be lucky if we end up in Antioch, more likely somewhere around Sacramento. Now that is just something I cannot get behind. Now this is why we're here, we sit here with Ace and with the Bellevue Hunters Point to demand the down payment against displacement.
Yeah.
We need to give ourselves a bit of a break so we can formulate the long-term plan. But for right now, we need to remain in our homes. We need to remain where we are. Are you guys with me?
Yeah!
All right, that's a little bit better.
All right. We're going to be in one voice.
One voice.
Now, we're going to be in one voice. So we got to practice our singing. We with you?
All right. In his 5-year reign as leader and leader to me, the displacement of the black community. In his 5-year reign as leader and leader to me, thousands of addictions and the displacement of the black of the black community. In his fire.
sign waiting for it right there.
At least, can't you see? At least, can't you see?
Not a good language.
Oh, I see where it is. Okay, right?
Yes, we're coming.
Okay, so where are we? Where is it? Another round of Ellis Act. So, yeah,
determined now, in fact, more determined now than before even, to fight and keep fighting. I've been out here for other people. People have been here for me. I think that the community is getting bigger. People are getting politically and socially conscious again, which is wonderful.
Amen.
And as far as Ed Lee goes, I didn't know anything about him when he got appointed or anointed, but he promised he wasn't going to run. As soon as he threw his hat in the ring, I said, this guy's a liar.
Yeah.
So I did not believe anything he said after that, and it looks like I was right.
All
he does is make deals with the rich, with the tech industry. Meets once a week with the tech industry. He's never met with anyone being evicted. I don't think he really cares. I don't know how these people actually function. Maybe they're wired inside of them instead of parts. It's really important because this isn't just for me, and it isn't just for the individuals here. It's for our city. This is the city of St. Francis. When I first came here in 1970, what I loved about this city were the people, this mix of all kinds of people. You go on the buses, you hear all kinds of languages, and to me, that's music. It was like a beautiful symphony. Plus, people were progressive, and they were active. You know, they didn't give us rent control from City Hall as a gift. People worked. They fought. They marched. They signed petitions. And here we go again. But this time we'll be stronger. It's like they keep prodding the dragon, the sleeping dragon. And I guess we're just going to have to burn them out. And I don't mean that in a literal way, so I don't want anyone to get bad ideas. But I just mean in a political and a social way, and in honesty. Let's let honesty throw them out.
All right.
Shine the light on all the dirt that's in this city and in the politics. So get your candles out. We're going to shine some light. Thank you.
We have to remember the reason why we're fighting, that every day someone's getting evicted. Our children of color are being profiled by the police, and we're under an administration that doesn't give a crap about the people who are helping make this city run. We have one more speaker who is actively fighting her eviction, so I'd like to... it's obviously a better situation.
Hi, my name is Kristen. I work at Las Americas around the corner from my house, and my landlady has also told us that she's putting up our buildings for sale on the market. I right away got involved working with MEDA, the Mission Economic Development Association, to buy our building. This is an amazing program they're trying to do, but we need money from the city to put the down payment on our building. The city is being difficult. They're not doing anything for low-income people like us. We have seniors. We have kids. We have 8 units in our building. No one in our building has money. There are people living on fixed incomes, people with kids going to school next door also, and we need help from Mayor Ed Lee. We need to demand action from the city. The city is not doing anything to help people with our housing stability. The most important thing practically in life is housing stability. What are we going to do? Where are we going to go? So I'm going to stand with Patricia to fight her eviction again, and I really appreciate you guys coming out. And what I just want to say is, Ed Lee, we need that money from Prop A to buy our buildings, to stay in the mission, for all of us to stay in the Bayview, to stay everywhere as much as we can. So.
And Midtown. So two more things, because we're going to actually do what our job here is to carol the hell out of him. But we do want a couple of the demands that we have, and I'm going to leave it to Pastor Dorn, because there are a lot of solutions out there, and we don't think they could be done quickly. However, Ed Lee has a lot of money, has a lot of rich friends. He's got a lot of developers and people he wants to move into San Francisco. So we're asking for a down payment for displacement that we want before December 31st, by January 16th. Because what happens out in January, actually early February?
Super Bowl!
Super Bowl! Is that for you?
Hell no!
Exactly. So let's start talking about that. So I'm going to leave it to Pastor Dorn to read our demands, and then we'll have to, we'll be singing.
And I don't know
know about you, but if we don't see action in January, I'm going to the Super Bowl. We'll be at the Super Bowl, and we will have a cloud of shame on San Francisco. They should be ashamed of themselves for what they're doing. So here's our list of demands. We demand a down payment against displacement. We want $20 million, and that's just a down payment. $20 million by January 2016. We want $10 million for small site acquisition, $10 million for distressed homeowners in the southeast sector. We also want to support Bayview 2020, five-year plan to protect, house, and bring back over 4,000 black families to Bayview Hunters Point and surrounding communities. Sincerely, your brothers and sisters from the Loving Ace community. Yeah! These are our demands. We expect our demands to be met. If they are not, we will be back. We have more songs to sing.
All right. I'm not going to use the bullhorn because it sounds really bad, but does everyone have their five-year reign as mayor?
It is 5 years as mayor, and we get to be thousands of evictions and displacement of the black community.
Let me hear you say it. these decorations. I see there's no decorations.
Yeah.
I guess he, Ebenezer Scrooge, he doesn't believe in Christmas. So we're actually doing him a favor. We're decorating.
I don't want to explain.
There's a railing over there.
It looks better already. Neighbors, we coming back. We will be back. We'll be back.
We will be back.
All right.